Welcome back to the Mortgage Marketing Update. I'm Brian DeMarie. I'm a loan originator with Union Home Mortgage and the DeMarie Lending Team. So hope you're not taking yourselves quite too seriously on a beautiful Thursday. Full of gratitude here today, guys. Let's talk about our mortgage bonds. They are down. There's a ton of volatility in the marketplace. I get this question all the time. If I had a dollar for every time somebody asked me, Brian, what are the interest rates? We're going to talk about it today. So as you can see, starting in January here, it's just kind of moving sideways here. And then we had a big decrease in our mortgage bonds, which then gives us an increase in our interest rates. So this is a big decrease, mostly because of the inflation talk and then the inflation reports that have come out. And this is a decrease in 216 basis points since December and January. It's a really big difference here. This next chart is called the VIX. It is a volatility index. And as you can see, that blue line going up, we have higher highs continuously. And then if you see those little blue arrows, the lows are getting higher. Those are then higher lows, which is then showing us that there's a trend. So it's probable we're going to see increased volatility as far as this chart goes. Here's another chart. It's called the Misery Index. It is a combination of inflation and unemployment. This is a five-year look. As you can see, we had this really big spike after going along very nicely. That big spike is from COVID. And you know, we had like 26.5 million unemployed, which is showing that as those folks started to get back to work, the chart is going down. And then it's starting to go back up again because we again have this all of this inflation talk. What does this mean as far as our interest rates? Quite a bit, actually. The reason I like to look at these charts so much is because when you know how to read the market, we don't have to rely on the media to tell us what the real narrative is. We can just look at a couple of key indicators. We can see that this is probably the direction things are going to be going in. So let's talk about some interest rates, right? Rates are the highest they've been since October 2019. So with perfect credit, 20% down and, you know, 740 plus in their credit score, they're looking at about 3.875 as far as their interest rate. But not everybody has that. So otherwise, they're looking at the fours right now. No matter what program we're looking at, FHA, conventional, if they're trying to do a cash out refinance, etc., they're doing, investment property, it's going to be even higher than that. But we are looking at interest rates in the fours. As far as points go, I would expect your buyers to have to pay points right now because margins are super thin with the lenders, and now they're going to have to compensate for that by adding points if they're going to get the interest rate to be a little bit lower. Pre-approvals, if your buyers have older pre-approvals, gonna have to go back and check all of those numbers with the lender that gave that to you. It's very possible that whatever the rates they were quoting a couple of weeks ago are not valid at this time. If your buyer has been trying to max out their ratios to buy the most expensive house possible, these new interest rates could very well invalidate the entire purchase price that they're approved for. They're gonna have to go back, reinsert a new interest rate to then at least find out where they really are. But remember, it's not just Union Home Mortgage that's experiencing this, it's the entire lending industry altogether. We're all really basically selling the same products when it comes to FHA and conventional. We have to follow all the same rules, and the rates are usually the same company to company. The only difference is we're not all selling the same service. Not everybody's available at 9 o'clock at night on weekdays and on the weekends to service your clients like Lily and I am. And when you see people like me jumping up and down about refi all over the place, it's because we know that the interest rates are increasing. But with all of this equity in the marketplace, the rates aren't really as relevant for a lot of folks if they're looking to do a cash out refinance, because most people are trying to seize the equity within all this appreciation so they can then realize the amount of money that they have in this house. Because remember, if it just goes up and down, it's sort of like you just had bought a stock that went up and then down without selling, without taking profits along the way. So a lot of buyers want to take that money out, either pay off student loans, pay off other debts, put, you know, improvements into the home. And now is still a really good time, because as the year goes on, we know that there is probably going to be more volatility and we can't get yesterday's rates tomorrow. So today's rate, even though it looks like it's a little bit higher than it was 2 months ago, is still going to be really appealing in July. And today at 11 o'clock, Lily will be doing a class in Spanish called Renovation Loans. It's another creative loan product that helps your buyer get to the finish line and put all the repairs into the loan. And it may not look like they want the house at first, but now that they find out they can get the kitchen and the bathroom exactly the way they want it, maybe it's a lot more of an appealing way, especially in a low inventory world. It's a really good tool to have in your back pocket. Lily and I want to be part of your business. If you know somebody that you think would benefit from a conversation with us, we would love to talk to them. Easiest way to send us their info, do us a quick text message with the buyer's name and number. We'll reach out today and get them pre-approved. All our videos are backed up on YouTube. Check us out on Instagram. Have a great day.